In the wake of the stunning Iraqi revolt, America intervenes in the explosive Mideast crisis. United States Marines pour ashore in Lebanon, their mission to protect American lives and property and to bolster the rebel-threatened Beirut regime. Curious and sometimes cheering crowds gather in welcome, making this one of the strangest operations of its kind in the history of the Corps. Overhead, fighter bombers of the 6th Fleet provide combat-ready sky cover for the Leathernecks. The temperature is in the 90s, tough going for troops in full combat pack, and enterprising ice cream vendors seize a grand opportunity. But despite its strange aspect, this operation is a gamble for high stakes, and the initial 1,800-man force moves swiftly to secure the Beirut airport, its initial goal. Later, their number almost doubled by a second wave, the Marines moved into Lebanon's capital city, carefully avoiding conflict and clashes with rebel groups. By a dramatic show of strength, the United States took a major step to restore stability in strife-torn Lebanon, drawing a clear line to bar further aggression in the ominously smoldering Middle East.
I'm well aware the landing of United States troops in Lebanon could have some serious consequences. That is why this step was taken only after the most serious consideration and broad consultation. I have, however, come to the sober and clear conclusion that the action was essential to the welfare of the United States. It was required to support the principles of justice and international law upon which peace and a stable international order depend. That, and that alone, is the purpose of the United States. We are not actuated by any hope of material gain or by any emotional hostility against any person or any government. Our dedication is to the principles of the United Nations Charter and to the preservation of the independence of every state. That is the basic pledge of the United Nations.
Even as the president's words were beamed to the nation and the world, a massive buildup was underway. A powerful force from the 2nd Marine Division at Camp Lejeune emplaned at Cherry Point, just one unit in the vast redeployment to back up the 5,000 already committed. Round the clock, a mighty airlift was underway. As these events took place, no one could be certain of the ultimate effect. One crucial question in this calculated risk was the reaction of Russia, whose interest in fomenting Mideast nationalism was threatened, and whose borders lie scant hundreds of miles north of Lebanon. No outright clash was anticipated, but a rapid buildup of American power in the area was crucial. Vast quantities of men and materiel began to flow. Marines were the spearhead of the operation, but they were not alone. From bases in Germany, one crack Army airborne unit, a full battle group, was flown to Adana Air Base in Turkey. The NATO base is now a staging area for our new Middle East command, with 1,600 paratroopers, fully armed and battle-ready, being held for further development. At the height of the march of events, Britain flew 2,000 paratroops from Cyprus into Jordan to thwart a new threat against King Hussein. The young monarch had also asked the United States for troops. In the past, Hussein had depended on aid from his cousin, deposed and slain King Faisal of Iraq to meet the menace of pro-Nasser radicals. Now, following the Iraqi military coup, pro-Western Jordan stood in grave peril. America's armed forces went out of a four-hour alert. The carriers Leyte, Hirschhorn, and Antietam loaded supplies for the Lebanon operation. Elsewhere, vessels being readied for mothballs were reactivated. From the Pentagon down, every American military unit everywhere in the world stood ready for any contingency. All leaves were canceled and port telephones were tied up for thousands of hasty farewells. America acted to stem the spread of indirect aggression that threatened world peace. Reaction of allies, neutrals, and enemies ranged from firm support through worried doubt to angry Russian threats. America's next step was to call upon the United Nations to act so that the Marines could be withdrawn. Ambassador Lodge explained America's action in sending troops into Lebanon.
The Council meets today to confront difficulties as serious as any in its history. The territorial integrity of Lebanon is increasingly threatened by insurrection, stimulated and assisted from outside. Plots against the Kingdom of Jordan, which have become evident over the past few months, are another sign of serious instability in the relations between nations in the Middle East. And now comes the overthrow, in an exceptionally brutal and revolting manner, of the legally established government of Iraq. Their presence is designed for the sole purpose of helping the government of Lebanon, at its request, in its efforts to stabilize the situation, brought on by the threats from outside, until such time as the United Nations can take the steps necessary to protect the independence and political integrity of Lebanon.